to run a marathon today.
That's stupid, Henry.
Okay, so here's what's going on. I had an idea. Actually, my good friend Zach had an idea. And he saw this guy on YouTube, Bo Miles, run a marathon by running a mile every hour for 24 hours.
I'm going to run 26 laps of my block in the next 24 hours.
And while he wasn't running, he was tending to a bunch of projects that he had been meaning to finish.
In between laps, I'll do as much as possible. Making things, odd jobs, cooking, fixing stuff.
And we both thought that was brilliant. The only problem was, Zach said he's seen the way I run and doesn't think I'm cut out to do it. And I agree with him completely. I've never run more than probably 4 miles in my life. Bo, on the other hand, seems to be an accomplished athlete. But what better time to run a marathon? But what better time to run a marathon with no training to get a bunch of done on a Monday than today? I haven't left the house in 2 weeks. So today, I'm gonna run a marathon and tend to a bunch of things that I need to get done. Here's how it's gonna go. So the first hour will be a 3 mile run. And then I will run 1 mile every hour on the hour for the following 23 hours in the day. And in doing so, I will have run a marathon. In between all the running, I've come up with a list of things I need to get done today, list of projects that I'll do in between all the running, such as get a haircut, hang some pictures for my parents, edit some photos, some work in the garage, apply for a patent, list all of the parts on the 1966 Ford Mustang, fastback for a project doing with a friend. It's either gonna be one of the most productive days of my life or one of the hardest. Stick with me to find out. It's 8:52 in the morning. I think it's time to begin.
Just finished my first mile. Mile two has just passed.
Yeah. 3 miles done. Now I will tend to that list of things to do. Because this is the shortest interval I have, I'll probably just be answering a day's worth of emails, making a couple phone calls before I go run my next. By the way, I lost a bet in Tanzania, so that has to be hung there for 3 months. Don't. Me and Dale were singing, little runaway. Emails. I was flying. Done. Yeah, running down a dream that never would come to me. Working on a mystery. Going wherever. Okay. So what I need to do, I have 45 minutes, is basically saw off all the treads.
You see this part that's hanging over here?
First things first. Okay. I need an extension cord and glasses. Always wear safety glasses. Oh, it's this close. And that's as close as it's gonna get because...
Yeah, you see, that doesn't really work like that. I could probably bend it back, but I'm a little worried about the structural integrity.
This was my first real project, and I don't think I'm gonna get it done today. So instead, I'm gonna take you on a tour
of the garage that's almost done.
The new chapter of this channel is gonna be taking place up here. Check this.
Wow.
By the way, everything I did in here, just about every single thing I did in here, I learned on YouTube. Go out, learn something new, make something happen. It's not as hard as you think. Yeah, running down a dream. More emails. Someone called Chase.
I'm in the park.
While I wait on the phone for Chase, also gotta find a developer for an app that I'm building right now. Anything was possible.
I'm at 6.4 miles, about 20 miles left.
Edit this big panorama of Chicago skyline.
1 p.m. I am still on hold with Chase. It's been an hour and 30 minutes.
An hour and 30 minutes.
Here we go. 7th mile.
Ooh, somebody's calling me. He wants to FaceTime.
Yes, Goff. Wait, I gotta hang up. I've been on hold with Chase for an hour and a half. I've been trying to call him for 2 weeks. I'll call you later.
No. I answered his call and it hung up on Chase.
This is extremely tedious.
Just finished mile 8,
but I gotta hang here.
I finished the sketch for the photos, it's to scale, everything's ready. The only problem is, I couldn't actually hang them because everybody's working from home, so I didn't think it was a good idea to be hammering on the walls. It's time for a haircut.
Oh no!
8 minutes?
I gotta go. How's it look? The sky grew
dark. That's not bad. I put
the pressure. Starting mile 9. The 10th mile is about to commence. I took a quick shower because the hair all over my torso itched so bad for my haircut. That's 10.7 miles. I'm picking up.
I gotta learn this solo. If there's one thing I learned from practicing classical piano, slow and steady wins the race. Disclaimer, by the way, I don't really play electric guitar. I just bought this one day because I thought it looked cool. All right, let's do it with the music. Let's see what happens here. Good for a half an hour.
Consider it done.
Doing that little dance that Angus Young does. I almost pulled both of my quads.
It's dinner time. But I think I'm about to hit 14. About to cross the halfway mark. Let's go.
Geos. 8 p.m. 15th mile. Everything hurts. Put it here. Yes. Mile 16. It's 9 p.m. That means I've been doing this for 12 hours. Here we go. Mile 17. I'm actually feeling pretty good on this one. Should I run it back? Knock out a second one? I'm not gonna run another one. Mostly because I don't know if it'd be a good idea to sleep and postpone. Like, I'm just gonna get more sore, so gotta keep pushing away on the hour, every hour. All right, it's 11 p.m. This is the start to mile 18. Really get my legs to start. Here we go. Come on, Henry, push. Come on. 1, 2, 3, go. Push. My legs won't work. Come on. Legs work. Oh, no. It's over. Last try. Here we go. Zach, you're right. Well, this wasn't the outcome I hoped for at all. That's good. You got to see me crumple and fail in real time, and that's pretty special. In the age of the internet, it's important to remember that I could have buried all of this footage away. I could have attacked this challenge again in a week or two, learning from my stretching mishaps, and probably been successful. Nobody would have known. But that's awfully cheap, isn't it? Instead,
I hope that this highlights the fact that a lot of the things that I do, I don't get right the first time. But knowing what I know now, I will conquer this someday. Zach, you just might have to join me. Anyway, one of my favorite YouTubers, Mark Rover, a roaring optimist, is asking his audience to find ways that they can punch coronavirus in the face. This was me doing my best on a Monday to not succumb to the boredom that could be present from being forced to stay inside all day. And remember, if I can run 17 and a half miles, never having run more than 4 in my life, not training or stretching properly, then you too can push yourself to be more extraordinary than you ever thought in every single way. Look, take out the running and I stopped putting off a bunch of long-term project emails that I needed to send. I listed nearly every part on a 1966 Mustang, getting me miles, no pun intended, ahead for a project I'm doing with a friend. I designed a photo gallery for my parents, got a haircut, learned a guitar solo, found out that it only costs $65 to file for a provisional patent yourself, cooked my family dinner, and caught up on reading. To write the day off as a failure would be a huge mistake. Go punch coronavirus in the face, whatever that looks like in your life. In other news, I'll be donating my $1,200 stimulus check to Feeding America, a nonprofit responsible for stocking tens of thousands of food pantries around the nation with essentials to feed nearly 50 million Americans. If you're able, I implore you to do the same. Okay, that's it for me now. I'll see you soon. I'm launching a new series on this channel called 1 Week Startup when this is all over. It's gonna be a ton of fun and really put my entrepreneurship skills to the test. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up below. It really helps. Consider subscribing if you wanna see more of my nonsense. And in the meantime, stay healthy, but more importantly, stay happy. We totally got this. All right, on to the next one. Woo! I'm learning to fly.